Will you please rise while the colors pass? It's the Marine Corps affiliate of the Parker. Marine Corps, that's part of our post, led by Commander Rudd. And salute.
And salute.
Okay. And Pastor, would you please come up for vocation?
Let us pray. Almighty Father, of all mankind and judge over all nations, we pray you guide us in our work in all our days. Send your peace to our nations and to all nations. Hasten the fulfillment of your promise of peace that shall never end. We pray for all those who serve the people and guard the public welfare, that by your blessing they may be enabled to discharge their duties honestly and well. We pray for our members, that by your help they may observe the strictest justice and keep alight the fires of freedom, strive earnestly for the spirit of democracy, and preserve untarnished our loyalty to our country and to you. We especially ask your blessing and comfort for all those who are suffering from the ravages of war. May our duty to them be ever alive in our minds. Finally, O God of mercy, we remember lovingly before you our departed heroes who received from you the reward of everlasting life. May their splendid example guide us now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
I want to welcome everybody coming out here to our 100th anniversary today. It's been a great day. It's a great legion here. I've been around a while and everything, and I just had a great time here. President of the Ladies Auxiliary, Ann Whitney, would you please come up and do the Pledge of Allegiance?
Hands low.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have Tim Bradley, police officer from Bergen County. I'm sorry, Barrett. Tim Barrett. He's going to represent the Bergen County Police Drummond pipe the court. Tim, would you play a medley of the song for about 3 minutes?
Thank you.
And right now I'd like to introduce the Mayor of Park Ridge. Mayor.
Thank you, Commander.
Sorry I'm running a few minutes late. I was just with our Congressman Josh Gottheimer, who should be here momentarily as well. I have a proclamation to read. Whereas the American Legion was chartered by Congress in 1919 on September 16th as a wartime veterans organization. Whereas the Park Ridge American Legion was founded in September 1919 as a Pascack Valley Memorial Post 153 and went on later to be named the Corporal Jedh C. Barker American Legion Auxiliary Post 153, honoring Lance Corporal Jedh C. Barker, who died in heroic service of his country in September of 1967 and subsequently received the Medal of Honor in 1969. And whereas Corporal Jedh C. Barker American Legion Auxiliary Post 153 has been honored and highlighted as they celebrate 100 years while sanctifying their comradeship, promoting peace and goodwill on earth, and to safeguard and transmit to posterity the principles of justice, freedom, and democracy. And whereas, over the years, the American Legion has become the preeminent community service organization, which now encompasses more than 2.5 million members, men and women, in over 14,000 American Legion posts worldwide, and benefits our nation's veterans, its service members, their families, the youth of America, and its citizens. And whereas the members of the American Legion are dedicated to upholding the ideals of freedom and democracy while working to make a difference in the lives of all fellow Americans. And whereas the Corporal Jedh C. Barker American Legion Memorial Post 153 organized and started the annual Memorial Day Parade, which has now become the largest patriotic parade in all of New Jersey. And whereas the Corporal Jedh C. Barker American Legion Post 153 promotes many townwide and community events, including and sponsoring of baseball teams, boys and girls programs, golf outings, and annual picnics, and has donated thousands of dollars to various charities. And whereas the American Legion Post 153 built Doughboy Veterans Park Memorial to honor all veterans. And whereas Corporal Jedh C. Barker American Legion Memorial Post 153 organizes and hosts a yearly remembrance in Park Ridge of those lost on September 11, 2001. And whereas the American Legion succeeds depends entirely on active membership, participation, and volunteerism, the organization belongs to the people it serves and the community in which it thrives. And whereas the American Legion is committed to mentoring young, sponsorship of wholesome programs in our community, advocating patriotism and honor, promoting strong national security, and continued devotion of our fellow service members and veterans. And whereas the borough of Park Ridge is forever grateful for their service, valor, sacrifice, and continued support of our community. Now therefore, I, Keith Meshag, the mayor of the borough of Park Ridge, do hereby recognize and pay tribute to the Corporal Jedh C. Barker American Legion Auxiliary Post 153 and congratulate them on this auspicious occasion of their 100th anniversary. And on a personal note, I could not thank everybody that's standing up here anymore, because we always talk about community service. I don't think what the Legion does can be any more important, and they always do it with a willing hand, and they're so active in the community. On a personal note, I'd like to thank you all very much. Congressman Josh Gottheimer. Got a microphone?
Is it okay if I speak for a second? Is that okay? Thanks. I just have some things for you I just wanted to bring.
The
Is it okay if I speak for a minute?
Go right ahead.
Thank you very much.
I got my phone. Good.
Thank you so much.
There you go.
Thank you very much. Hope everyone can hear. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Post Commander Clary, Centennial Chair, Mr. Bazone, our excellent mayor, Keith Mishagna, who's been just such a good friend of our veterans, as is our councilman, Medzorf, who has also been an excellent friend of our veterans and our community. I am very, very grateful and honored to be here this morning. I'm always glad that our community has the American Legion, and by extension, all of you and your families who are here on the side for the important work that you all do for Bergen. I'm honored to be here, of course, with all of you and this beautiful community on a beautiful day. Commander, I was honored to be part of this installation back in May. You know, when you think of these moments in our history, and you try to understand the full expanse of our time. I was with my son and daughter this morning, talking to them and saying I'm actually honored to be going to three legions today. And the reason why I'm going around to more than one legion to spend time and to say thank you and to honor the 100 years is because when you've spent moments in Washington and you have a chance to do and stand up for veterans, and people say to you, thank you for standing up to veterans, my response always is, I have an obligation. No one should ever thank any of us in Washington for what we do for veterans. All that people in Washington should do is thank the men and women who've served our great country. When I walk in every day to vote, the democracy that I'm honored to represent and our great country is strong and standing strong for one simple reason: for the people standing next to me. And it's because of you that we all have the freedoms that we have. And despite what our country faces over time, the ups and downs, the tough times, the good times, we should all remember and never forget those who've given the ultimate sacrifice to protect our democracy. And then who came home, no matter what time, no matter what war, no matter what conflict, to provide assistance to others who've served. Every year, the American Legion provides assistance to more than 181,000 VA claims and cases, awards more than $4 million in scholarships, is the nation's single largest donor of blood in the country, the single largest. At Post 153, from collecting unserviceable flags to sponsoring Boy Scout Troop 334 to working honorably discharged veterans with those honorably discharged who may need financial assistance to helping honor those who served from the greatest generation, especially during this centennial celebration, you all have been a force for good in so many ways. And all this work does so much to promote the four pillars of the Legion: Americanism, a strong national security, kids and youth, and taking care of our veterans. But not just that, you are all an anchor, as I said, of our community, serving as a place where veterans and their families and friends can come together to have a sense of family and common purpose when you return home. So I will continue doing my job, as I said, because it goes without saying that we get the backs of those who get ours, whether it's veterans or law enforcement or EMS or active duty, because I'll never forget that service and never forget what you stand for in the four pillars when you come home. So in the House, we've passed, and we must all work for it, to deal with the vacant staff vacancy crisis at the VA, to boost investment in hiring more mental health professionals, to deal with, and I was just on the phone this week, those facing long waits and long drive times and canceled appointments and subpar care at certain aspects of our VA, which we should be fighting for. To me, that's the basic responsibility when you come home, that we should do for you. We should be making sure we help with back pays and claims and records issues or medals. And my office door is always open, and I hope you will feel you should always come to me if you need anything at all. to finish with this point, 100 years strong and 100 years going forward. Thank you, and God bless you and your families for always protecting us, for protecting our democracy, and for being there for us. Today I have two things to present to you. I will not read you the proclamation, but I have a proclamation which I submitted into the congressional record on this centennial. This is now in the congressional record. And I also brought for you a flag for this post, which flew over the United States Capitol in honor of this centennial. And if I could present it to you, sir, I'd be honored. Who should I present to? You, both of you? Either one of you? You,
Joe.
Thank you so much. May God bless you and your families.
Thank you.
Of course, yeah, we'll go. Okay, we'll go over here. Thanks.
I want to introduce the Boy Scouts of a PAC that we sponsor. Please come forward. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Okay, I just want to thank you for your service. Thank you for honoring us here. Just want to say thank you from Troop 334. For sponsoring the troop and supporting us throughout all the years and supporting the Eagle Scouts. We just have a little plaque here for you to support, to actually celebrate the 100 years. And this is for you.
Thank you. Joe, you want to?
Yeah.
Come on out
here. Just come out and.
Little Scouts.
Look at that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Now you're going to introduce? Okay. Oh, thank you very much.
This is pure water, not anything else you might be thinking of. I'd like to introduce preeminent soloist of Park Ridge. Lori Fredericks, who will sing It's a Grand Old Flag. Lori.
Patriotic lady, I'm a dead square honest Yankee, and I'm mighty proud of that old flag that flies for Uncle Sam. Though I don't believe in raving, every time I see it waving, there's a chill runs down my back that makes me glad of what I am. Red, white, and blue, hats off to you. Honest, you're a grand old flag. You're a grand old flag, you're a high-flying flag, and forever in peace may you wave. You're the emblem of the land I love, the home of the free and the brave. Every heart beats true neath the red, white, and blue, where there's never a boast or brag. But should old acquaintance be forgot, keep your eye on the grand old, eye on the grand old flag.
Are you up there?
As the congressman said 100 years ago today, we were chartered. I don't know whether the congressman mentioned it. None of us were present, however, at that day. I was going to give a brief history of the post, but we have at least 100 flyers inside that afterwards we're asking everyone to come in. We have a mini museum that was created just for today. And I wanted to thank Linda Mackey for supervising her merry band of men and women who spent many, many hours putting this museum together. It consisted of our post members, the members of Auxiliary 153, and the Sons of the American Legion. I'll just digress for a minute to say that the Scout Troop of 334 is one of the oldest in the United States. It goes back, I believe, something like 90 years, and we're very, very proud of them. Mayor, besides Councilman Metzdorf, are there any other council people present? This is the first year I had the pleasure of working with Bob Metzdorf on 9/11, a patriot, and he did an excellent job, as his predecessor has done. I'd like to have our commander and former councilman, Bob Opel, come to the... we're doing something unique today. Bob is a United States Navy veteran of the Vietnam War. And he's going to be sworn in today. He'll be the first member of the second century to be sworn in as a member. And that in itself is a great honor, I believe. So the commander will render the swearing in.
Okay. Say, repeat after me and put your name in there. I,
Robert Opelt.
Do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear the truth and faith, acknowledgement of the same, and that I will obey the orders of the President of the United States.
I will.
And the orders of the officers appointed over me, so help me God.
So help me God.
The oath of enlistment, we ask young men and women to pledge this us when they make the decision to join the service, and they make the commitment to be sure to tell that them you are the service that we are proud of them and that we are. But we cannot continue to send 18 and 19 year olds troops overseas for fight our battles without a commitment here at home. For now and when I say the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag, I will repeat the oath of enlistment and act as faith to our soldiers and our country. And I want to congratulate you.
Thank you, Commander.
First member.
Thank you, sir. I spent 7 years on the council. Six and a half of them were working with the Legion. Very interesting time in my life. A lot of these things happen not because of they just do. A lot of work. Dick spends hours putting these events together, and I personally appreciate his effort, the commander's effort, and also the fact that he sponsored me for membership. So thank you very much.
The normal enlistment for a member of the American Legion is 3 years. We made an exception. You will be on a member for the next 99 years. Hopefully you will be around.
Hoping to make the 100 years.
Okay. At this time, we want to call my first vice commander. We have a number of proclamations to read. We're going to recognize by name those that sent the proclamations, but we will only have two people. The mayor has already spoken, the congressman has spoken, and I believe we have one other. But as John reads off the names.
All right, so the following are proclamations that are going to be available for everybody to view afterwards inside for the rest of the afternoon. And I'm just going to go down the list here, starting with President Donald Trump, Senator Robert Menendez, County Executive James Tedesco, Board of Chosen Freeholders of Bergen County, the Borough of Woodcliff Lake, Mayor Carlos Rendo, the Borough of Montvale, Mayor Michael Glahassi. We also have a joint resolution from the Senate and the General Assembly. We also, that includes Senator Gerald Cardinale, Assemblywoman Shepesvi, also Assemblyman Orth, which is also, these are also signed by Stephen Sweeney, the President of the Senate, and Craig Coughlin, the Speaker of the General Assembly. There's also a proclamation from Governor Phil Murphy, along with our Bergen County American Legion, also the Bergen County Clerk John Hogan, and you've already heard from Troop 334 of the Montvale Boy Scouts. That's the list. Thank you.
As you know, our post has been in existence for 100 years. Today's one of the few times that we've been honored to have a congressman, Josh Gottheim, here with us, and we hope to have him visit us quite often. For the first time in the history of this post, I had asked a member of our auxiliary, Dorothy Bazone, to take over and handle the proclamations program. And for the first time in the history of our program, or our chapter, I'm sorry, our post, we received a personal letter, which I'd like to read. I'm sure the congressman has met him, and stated September 12th, 2019. Melanie and I send our warmest greetings and congratulations to the Jedh C. Barker, Corporal Jedh C. Barker Memorial American Legion Post 153 in celebration of your 100th anniversary. Since 1919, the American Legion and its members have proudly served our nation's veterans, military families, and communities. Through your commitment to the mission of the Legion and the values of our nation, your post has helped to strengthen the spirit of patriotism and enduring faith in American greatness. During this special celebration, we thank all those who have served our country with courage and distinction. May God bless each and every one of you, and may he continue to bless the United States of America. Signed, the President of the United States, Donald S. Trump. It's the first time in the history of our post that we have received this. And it will, since the Great War, First World War, 26 Park Ridge men have died serving our country. 5 were killed in World War I, the Great War. 12 were killed during World War II. 2 were killed during the Korean War, and 5 were killed during the Vietnam War, including the namesake of our post. We ask that you would remain seated for 30 seconds, and Dot Bazone is going to toll a bell for 4 or 5 times, every 10 seconds if you would. Mayor is going to say a few more words in behalf of the local men who have served and died.
Thank you, Dick. I just want everyone to remember the families that these brave soldiers left behind. Their sacrifice could never be repaid, but we should remember the families that were left behind who every holiday, every party, every celebration, they have a void in their lives, and their sacrifice is just as great as the soldiers who put their lives on the line. So I would also like to take a moment of silence just to recognize the families and their sacrifices, if you would. Thank you.
We have members of the Barker family here today. We'd like them to stand and be recognized.
Liberty Bell.
Okay.
I'm married into it.
Okay, we'd have Tom and Drew come up and gonna bring the wreath and light up by over here.
That comes after this. Following the presentation of the wreaths, we will have Lori Fredericks sing. You want to announce who's coming?
We'll have the SAL bring up their wreath by Larry McKenna and Dennis Cosgrove. Okay, now we'll have the Ladies Auxiliary bring up the wreaths by Annie Whitney and Dee
Mackey.
Parkridge Mayor will bring out the wreath. Okay, we're going to play taps. Lori Fredericks is going to sing.
Again, we have the lovely Lori Fredericks.
Thank you. When Johnny comes marching home again, hurrah, hurrah. We'll give him a hearty welcome then, hurrah, hurrah. The men will cheer and the boys will shout. The ladies, they will all turn out. That joyful day when Johnny comes marching home. Get ready for the jubilee, hurrah, hurrah. We'll celebrate the victory, hurrah, hurrah. We'll all join in the big parade and let the soldier have his day. And we'll all feel great when Johnny comes marching home. When Johnny comes marching home again, hurrah, hurrah. We'll give him a hearty welcome then, hurrah, hurrah. We'll sound the horns and we'll beat the drums. Salute them all for a job well done. The joyful day when Johnny comes marching home.
Father Bob. Father Bob's got a benediction first.
Closing benediction.
Closing benediction, Father Bob.
Yep.
Father Bob.
Father Robert Mulak, curate at a Lady of Mercy Church.
Okay, Chris. Okay. All right. Is it on? I got it. Okay. First, I'd like to meet all your moms. Like, okay, why do we want another prayer? You'd rather get inside where it's cooler, out of the sun. But there's a difference between opening prayer and a concluding one. Grave is invocation, ask God to be with us. Benediction, ask God to bless all the things we've remembered. So very special in our gathering here. And it's not just the civic things, you know, the Boy Scout troop and all this. There's also the service of so many people. You know, you're reading out to say how many people in World War I. And you know, Park Ridge is a lot smaller in World War I. So as a ratio, that affected a lot more families than any of the others, really. But tragedies, sometimes forget people's names, or I just could be able to go inside earlier and take a look at some of the exhibits and all, which I invite everybody to go inside and take a look at those things. That we never forget what we remembered here this afternoon. The service, people's lives, how we affect one another. So Father, we humbly ask you to bless these moments together. Let us be your thankful people. Let us never forget what we have experienced. Let us never forget our memories. Our service to one another. Humbly we ask this, O Lord. Mighty Father, one God. Amen.
Now what do you want? Okay, color guard. Attention.
Color guard will now be dismissed.
Dismissed.
And salute.
Salute.
Okay, now I want to thank everybody for coming out, and it's upstairs. We got a lot of museum stuff there, and it's nice and cool.
Johnny, get your gun, take it on the run, Hear them calling you and me, every son of liberty. Hurry right away, no delay, go today. Make your daddy glad to have had such a lad. Tell your sweetheart not to pine, to be proud her boy's in line. Over there, send the word over there. That the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming. The drum, drum coming everywhere. So prepare, say a prayer. Send the word to beware. We'll be over, we're coming over, and we won't come back till it's over, over there. Johnny, Johnny, get your gun, get your gun, get your gun. Johnny, show the Hun you're a son of a gun. Hoist the flag and let her fly. Yankee Doodle, do or die. Pack your little kit, show your grit, do your bit. Yankees to the ranks, from the towns and the tanks. Make your mother proud of you, and the old red, white, and blue. Over there, send the word over there. That the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming. The drum, drum coming everywhere. So prepare, say a prayer. Send the word, who'll beware. We'll be over, we're coming over. And we won't come back till it's over, over there. So prepare, say a prayer. Send the word to beware. We'll be over, we're coming over. And we won't come back till it's over, over there.
We won't come back till it's over, over there.